Sorry about that, the capture of the sound was not working properly. Now it should be. I will turn the volume down a bit as soon as I have opportunity for that.
The twin queens, the sisters, have sent their most beloved commander, Vor, on an urgent mission.
What's this mission about?
To protect the twisted crusade they have begun. To transform the scattered colonies into an empire. To see that the Tenno, hidden and asleep, will never awake.
I got caught.
Who is the Tenno? What is the Tenno? Are they looking at shiny stars through window? Is this guy about to break the stars? No, he's turning the stars into gold. Okay, so it seems that now we are facing a choice. Give me just a moment. Change a couple settings here. Ooh. Let's just apply some changes. Cool, there we go. So I have no idea what to choose. Okay, it says that Excalibur is the guy that is perfect for new players. I guess that I will go with that. I don't want to have problems by being cocky. I need to change the resolution because clearly the resolution is not that good. Yeah, but Biscuit, thank you very much for the host. Really appreciate it.
Pity she's too late. You're my prize now, Tenno. No! We are taking this one with us!
What has he done to you? I can't lose another Tenno. I am searching your Warframe's power systems.
I guess that we are strong. Let me see something. Is it possible to invite friends to join? How can I find a friend? I don't know. Let me see if I can guess my friend. User. Ooh, that's bad. I should be able to see something. That's stupid, because why can't you just like see friends from Steam or something? And now my screens are going completely bonkers. Sorry about that, but I am trying to essentially find my friend, and while I am waiting for his answer, let me just cancel this. I think that this is not the right one, and I just clicked on profile. Big. I don't know. I am confused. Oh, okay, add friend, yeah. Cool. I mean, I'm just sending friend requests as if there was no tomorrow. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe this is the right... I don't know. So while I'm waiting to get an acceptance, let me just see if it is possible to change game settings, like display. Yeah, I don't think that this is the right resolution for this screen at all, and that's noticeable. Ooh, much better now. Cool. I was cringing all over the place. Yeah, let's. So there is no option to like say. Cool. A lot of settings. No, refresh rate, fuck that. No. We have the nice and beautiful 144 Hz, so let's use it. Any settings for G-Sync or whatnot? No, I think that I will just run an optimization afterwards. Right now it's fine. I think that we don't need this because we have G-Sync. No need for the good old V-Sync. Okay, no worries. I'm not too concerned about not having the G-Sync disabled on the stream. Or not now. No limit, exactly. Shit, I'm getting 300 FPS since I changed the refresh rate. Cool. So I guess that for now this is like nice then. Communication, friends, and nothing yet. And just reapply something here. Cool. There we go. Sorry, really sorry about this, but I'm just trying to manage everything. We have a nice session and first game. Cool. So I don't know how this will go, but I will just start the tutorial. And the game is botched. Shit. I can't access like the full. Okay, no, I guess shit. It's like stuck here. Ah, man. Why? Why do you have to be so stupid? Okay, I think that I need to restart the game because I can't access like the right side of the screen. And that, as you might imagine, let me try to make this windowed. And
hello.
Hi. I'm having major problems with the game. Like,
oh man.
I changed the setting for resolution, and suddenly I lost like half of my window. I couldn't move my mouse to the edge of the window when I windowed out window in. Okay, let's see if now it's better. No, it is not. Shit. I will just restart the game quickly.
So I shouldn't mess with it, right?
I mean, mess with it, but my problem is that I windowed out and windowed in. I don't think that I have. I don't know if what will happen if I get out of the game and come back. I don't know. I think that I will just like get out of the game and come back because this is annoying. Why? Games and resolutions shit. And there is no option to exit, so I guess that I will just, yeah, I will just restart the game because it's not playable as it is right now. Oh, maybe, let's see if it is playable. It seems that it is. I won't be messing with that. Whoa, so I need to press on numbs to do actions. There is no way to do that just with key press on the mouse. Oh, by the way, I need to change something. Because the audio is way, like, really loud. make any sense.
So have you tried the tutorial thing or?
I am still alive. I just spawned. I don't know.
Where did you spawn?
After the cutscene.
But are you inside the ship or not?
No. I am just like.
Okay.
I added you as a
friend. You are in the tutorial.
I think yeah. that I am. Yeah. I added you as a friend, and it's still listing as pending. And
I'm trying to find
it. It's communications, and then friends.
All right.
I am really annoyed, mate, because. My character is a melee guy, and I, instead of pressing the left click to slash, I am forced to press number one. As you can imagine, that's not the optimal way to go.
Tell me your in-game game name.
I would love to.
Okay.
Let me just see. How the fuck do I see that? I would say IGR. I link this to my.
When Steam. You register your account, it asks you for an email and then your name.
Okay, so try IGR then, because usually I go for that.
Just those three letters.
No. Sorry, IGR CNDD.
On its way, but the grenade request sent.
So
I think I have you now. Yeah.
Yeah, I do.
No, it's pending, sorry.
Yeah, I accepted now. Yes, so cool. Let me just cancel the other two guys, because I have no idea who they are. I was trying your name, so now you should be... Yeah, now you are here. I don't know if I can invite you, because as you know... No, it's
invite squad member, I think.
There is no way. I just have talk, remove, and profile, so I guess that's not... Okay. I guess I need to finish this, I guess. Yeah. I would just like to know how to do the damn left click to attack. Okay, they're showing me that the sprint is the shift. Can pick up a weapon. And it seems that now on the left button I have something. Okay.
After you finish your tutorial, you will unlock the arsenal thing.
Mm. The ship and the way to what's your class, by the way, just so I understand?
The magnetic.
Okay, cool. I am the first one,
right?
Yeah, the one that they advised to choose for new players.
My ship is talking with me, that's funny. Good to know. I was like, what?
Okay, the ship talks with you? That's
apparently
neat.
So, yeah. I'm just trying the moves.
You
can slide and jump.
Yeah, you can do a lot of shit there. And I think that I need to reduce the sensitiveness. Manny is saying that it's strange to hear your voice after so long.
Yeah, I bet.
I have no idea. I really need to decrease the sensitiveness of the mouse, because it's like crazy high. Let's reduce a bit. And then they are not nice, because for mouse sensitiveness, you have 5 sliders.
Oh.
It like...
That's a lot.
It is. I think that it's like pushing it. Like, you can do wherever you can. But in the beginning, when you just want to say it's moving too fast, you are quick.
Yeah.
You are seriously screwed, because you have a lot of options.
There's a paradox for it. It's when there's too many options.
Yeah. It's like... Yeah, you always have...
I don't recall the name.
Overcomplicating.
Yeah, but there's a name for it.
I bet that it is. But.
Particular.
So there is... what I find strange is that the ships in this game look like a triangle with a, with a, with an, with the tail.
Yeah.
You're not ready to face more now. Use your melee weapon to block the beam and get inside.
Please just try to go through the tutorial because that will take you a little bit.
I am trying to block. Okay, I'm now moving.
At the very least, like 15 minutes.
Really?
Lock the area down. Yeah.
That long?
Yep.
Okay. Get to the console and release the lockdown. I am doing that. Yeah. It won't take a lot of time. I am really good at this, so you will see that.
Okay. I'm joking. Yeah, I know that this game resembles Destiny. No, I mean,
it's not that, I mean in Destiny you don't have that many melee attacks, so it's okay. It's a bit faster than Destiny actually.
Well, you picked the melee guy, so it's warranted that you're going to have lots of melee.
And now I would like to... Oh fuck, the guy's attacking me.
Get out of there, Tenno. Oh, and by the way, don't worry too much on leaving things behind.
Mm-hmm.
You just have to touch them and it will equip it. It's not really equipped, it's just... He's going to collect it if you can collect it.
Okay,
but you're not supposed to pick everything, yeah.
Okay, I'm not. And do I need to worry about touching everything?
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
Sometimes they just fly out of bounds, so don't go in with them, because that will respawn you.
Okay, got it.
And you will not pick them.
I'm getting a notification that I have 20. I don't know, it was saying like 25 health. And now I'm trying to find the way to go out. And you. Is that the game? I guess that it is, because it's alpha. I'm trying to find the way to get out of here for the objective. Okay. So there was a door that was accessible to open. But it was red. I don't understand. For me, red means that I cannot go through. But this game says that red is okay to go.
There's also containers. And some are red, which you can't access. And then most of them are green, which you can interact with.
Yeah, I'm just seeing here now one. And the red one, I guess it's something. So now I need to choose a primary weapon. Either a bow or a machine gun. Yes, machine gun it is.
I'm not sure what war has done to your warframe, but we cannot remove it now. Just keep going. Your ship is up ahead.
There's a really nice slide to your character. You click control.
Mm-hmm. But
you are tackling in football.
Yeah, usually I know
it's
okay.
I mean, sorry.
I think that when you have like eye level, people tend to like use a lot of sliding because it's really fast and it seems to be like overpowered and all.
There it is, your ship. Hurry, Vor's reinforcements must be on their way.
I am about to get to my ship.
Disengage the suppression system so we can restart the ship. You'll have to bypass
you
the
think
security
so?
On that panel.
No, they say... I don't understand what the... See, this has a pattern. Okay, got it. I wasn't understanding how to unlock this mechanism.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. Oh.
Is that you?
Yeah, usually FPSs nowadays have like crazy amounts of customization. In Fallout you can do whatever you want with the weapons. It's actually a bit almost excessive, I would say. I mean I went through the game and I only applied customization to one single weapon.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't bother, to be honest, but I think that I will eventually buy the DLC Because it's actually a fun game to play.
Oh, it's a particular DLC.
No. You can customize weapons. Yeah, you have no. What I'm saying is, I played the full game without customizing a lot, but yeah. I'm not thinking about replaying the original game. My idea is I might go back to the game when I buy the DLC. That was what I meant.
But what features the DLC?
New stories. Like adds a lot of story to the game. The ship is ready. Mm-hmm. And in my opinion, that's the way to go. Because the game, I mean, the main focus for me, at least for the game, is just story. It is crazy. The story is nice, and I know that, I think that they messed up a bit in the sense that they didn't allow you to, like, they kind of budged a bit on the way that you go through the story in the beginning, at least.
And it's not survival anymore.
It is. Right? It's hard to survive.
It's more like, let's just build a settlement and that's it.
How it was before, because I never played any other game, so I don't know what you mean by it's not survival anymore.
Everything that you face in your game, like you are trying to find food and things like that. Mm-hmm. And then everything tries to do the same, and they eventually, if you face somebody, they're really powerful, and usually you don't have a chance.
Okay.
If you play really well, you have a chance. You can even do like crazy stuff, like robbing them and things like that.
Okay. Yeah. And this one is not. I mean, in the end, you actually start having like that crazy stuff about you now need to be careful, because you will be dying fairly easily. But yeah, it's mostly not that.
There's always a good chance to miss your shots and things like that, which I don't.
Oh, but this one has that as well. But you don't focus as much using that. I'm just restarting the game because I was trying to fix that problem with the resolution, and I already did the tutorial. I'm already in the ship.
Oh, cool.
Did you?
I was about to say that in your ship, if you still didn't look at it, there is a corner where there is like an infestation of scarabs, black and red.
Really?
Yeah. Where?
Let me just try to check that.
Go down?
Yeah. Left or right?
Left.
The left. Give me just a moment. And yeah, I see. The fuck is this?
Don't ask me, I don't know.
Do you know how much frames per second my PC is generating inside the ship?
Tell me.
370 frames per second.
Wow. It runs very, very smoothly in mine.
It has to, or else you wouldn't be able to play, right? It says that I need to restore ship comms. I guess that I need to come here. Yeah, there is a console to do so.
Yeah, no, but I have that mission too. I hope we can play it together.
No. But thing is, I was just... He was saying that I really needed to, activate the thing. Cool. Yeah. So it seems that now I can customize my character, but I won't be doing that. I have no idea what to do, so I will just leave it as it is. Wait. Let's see if I can change the...
I just realized that I picked a female character.
How do you do that?
I don't remember.
How do you
I think
do
it's, it? It depends on your class.
Okay. Oh, look at that. You can pay Steam money to get new skins. Lovely. Oh. And that's exactly what I will do. Being completely honest, my main question here is, can I sell them?
And can exactly.
If I can farm and sell, fuck yeah, mate, I will play this game as if there was no tomorrow. By the way, the game has cards, so...
Oh, cool.
Yes, you will be able to get cards just by playing the games. Steam trading cards.
Free-to-play games usually don't Unless you spend money on them, they don't drop cards. They have them, but they will not drop.
Ah, okay.
They are like rewards for engaging. So only if you put money in, you'll get them.
Okay.
Oh, so let me see if I can accept your...
And you say that this game is like ex-realism because you will have a lot of shit going here, or you are just saying that about the game that you are talking about, Escape from Tarkov Alpha. By the way, a game that I'm also thinking about picking up is the... I will be disabling the voice chat in-game. No, but this is chat, or else... I prefer Steam, I think. Sorry, Discord. Yeah. Where is this shit? Enable voice. Disable voice. Yes, cool. That way, my... Yeah, I am now disabled. Cool.
Should I do it too?
I mean, I'm not hearing your voice through the game, so I don't know what to do. You might need to press a button to do so. So
exactly.
It's fine.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Cool. So it seems that now we are in the ship. I think that we are in the same phase of the game.
At least. Okay. I hope so.
So I need to restore ship comms, and I'm going to navigation. Oh, okay, Annie, okay. I will have a look into that game. Is it new or? And I think that now you will do essentially wherever I go, you will go with me.
Yeah.
Okay. No, sorry. It seems that this mission is single player.
Oh. Okay.
So we will need to do it separately.
Okay. I'll do mine too.
Okay. Yeah. And hopefully. But how did you spend 30 minutes or 20 minutes on that first mission?
I think I was exploring everything.
Ah, okay. I know.
Secrets and shit.
The thing is, you will. I think that you will go through a lot of these maps multiple times. Like, it's not exclusive. The maps are not exclusive to missions like Destiny. In Destiny, essentially, you can go through the same map multiple times through different routes. By the way, their designs of maps are not bad, but I think that it's like they... I would say that they are not, like, perfect.
Yeah.
It's like, being completely honest, feels to me like the same design that they did with Mass Effect 1. In Mass Effect 1, the maps were not, like, that great, because old game and whatnot. Okay, cool. By the way, do we have ammo? Oh, I guess that we do, because I just picked up a box of ammo and said that ammo was full. Oh, okay. So it's even alpha, so... Yeah, but nowadays, most games are alpha forever. And early access forever.
Right.
It's like the way to go. I mean, I don't mind at all, because I'm not one that will say I will not pick up a game just because it's early access. Wouldn't care less for that. Oh, by the way...
I usually think twice, not even twice, mm-hmm. or before picking one of those.
Okay. I mean, but obviously I will only go for one of these games when I think that it's a game that will be have like a lot of potential. For instance, I still think that No Man's Sky will be an amazing game. I think that Astroneer will be I do. I think that the game will grow a lot. It's clear with the thing about building the base, they add such a depth to the game, and it's literally just a layer that you build a home base, and then with that they actually added a lot of functionality. So now with the base you need to search for people to work with you, and it's all that jazz. By the way, on this first mission, I don't know what to do.
Just keep moving.
Yeah. Oh, sorry. There is a mini map, and the mini map says where you need to go. Yeah. Do your guy has a melee attack that allows you to grab guys from behind and snap their neck?
Yeah, I think.
Oh, cool. Yeah, mine does as well, and that's actually funny.
And I have throwing stars.
Ninja all the way. I have like a kind of a metal pole.
Oh, okay.
That does a bit of damage on people. But being completely honest, with so much gizmos, I don't know what to do. Do I shoot them? Do I beat them up?
Yeah, I get that feeling too.
I just got something. Like something that enhanced my weapon, my pistol or something. Let's say that I think that this game, we are like, at least I'm feeling like you do. That's a shame, man. It's annoying when people do that, but I guess that most of the times when I buy an alpha game, I end up like, I play the game in the beginning, I give it a bit of time, and then I come back whenever there is an update, and so on and so on. Sorry, but wait a minute, as I was saying, I think that we are, at least I am feeling that I am suffering from the usual an alpha game that started being really simple. People complained a lot because the game was too simple. Suddenly the game is really complex and everyone is happy, but if you start playing the game now, you'd have no fucking idea what to do. The curve is too steep for new players. It's like a bit like a RimWorld. You need to put a couple of hours into the game until you actually understand, and even after those hours, it is still, being completely honest, I now understand a lot of mechanisms, but I had to spend a full week playing on the easy mode, trying them out.
What game is that?
RimWorld.
Oh, right.
So... Oh, okay. Seems that I had to slide to go through the door, or through the an elevator to go up or down. Okay, no, I don't need the elevator. Cool. I don't understand the crosshair has a lot of has four dots. I have no idea what those dots mean. Cool. And do you have any idea why nowadays so much players are playing this game? Like a lot of streamers started playing this game. Oh, okay. Sorry. But thing is, No Man's Sky needs a... Sorry. Go on. Wee Demon. Go on.
No, I was asking
No, I have no idea. I've seen...
Okay, sorry.
I've seen like shitloads of streamers playing this game, and being honest, I'm not like trying to give shit to those guys or not. I couldn't care less. But some of them actually heard them saying at some point, I don't want to play that game because I don't have time, and unless there is something, I will never play this game. And then suddenly they start playing the game, and I'm like, what the fuck? Why the fuck are you playing the game now? And being honest, that might be a little bit the reason that I'm playing this game as well. Not because they are playing, obviously, but just because I was curious. Yeah. And... Okay, so it seems that I have a trigger to do something. And I am stuck here.
If you just said something, I didn't hear.
No, I got it. And I got it, Tanya. I got that the comment was about No Man's Sky. And was that what I was about to say to you? Was that I need to go up what I was saying is that No Man's Sky, I think it's a really nice game. I mean, you just need to take it with a grain of salt, and you need to understand that it's a game that is starting. The game is not ready yet, and that's the thing. You might hate them because their strategy was to essentially take all of your money and then run away. I don't think that they are running away, but essentially it's a game that will need time to evolve, and it's not like, oh, the game is done and that's it. Not at all like that. It's a game that, I mean, it's a bit like Astroneer. The game started, people got a little bit of content, and now if you want more content, you need to wait. Unfortunately, that's it. If you are too eager to have that new content, I mean, don't buy the game yet and wait till the game is finished. There is nothing. Yeah. it's annoying that I think that regarding the stream lag, I think that some chaps are already implementing nice technologies like Beam as a technology called FTL that essentially allows you to stream with 2 milliseconds of delay or something like that. So that will obviously help a lot on these scenarios of stream lag. It is something that annoys me a lot and leaves me really, really confused. Is when I'm having a conversation with someone and then suddenly the conversation doesn't make sense just because there's a delay on the conversation. It's annoying. Cool, my guy has an ability that when I jump and I melee, the guy just adds a powerful beating down that smashes the players. It is cool. Yeah, but I think that I've heard the story of these guys, the guys that developed this game, and I think that it goes something like we developed the game because we like the game.
Yeah.
We enjoy doing it, and we actually got we started the game because we all got off our jobs and we started this game, and the game was popular. Suddenly there was shitloads of investment, and now the game is just crazy. We have money to do whatever we want for a lot of years, even if we don't get any more money from the game.
That's awesome.
Yes.
Check navigation. The system continues to fall into chaos. Check navigation for active invasions.
Cool, so I just finished the mission. The operator
has recovered a segment. I'm almost done.
Cool. I am getting all alerts now. As soon as you get out of the mission, they tell you all about everything. It's a bit overwhelming, to be honest. Systems engaging. I suppose this will do. Ordis is grateful. And I guess that makes sense, because it is not realistic to say that you will be able to deliver everything in the game. Cool. I don't think that it makes sense to say that you will get everything in the game. I think that we have currency in game.
Yeah.
And when you see the skins, it will be really good. When you see there is a skin called Frost Arska. It looks really, really cool. I think it's one of the Steam thing. Okay, yeah, but it costs a lot of money. Steam money or real money. And it's cheers, but I will not be. Not for now, I don't think. What's the shortcut to get... Okay, yeah. There was the shortcut to get out of the menu was actually on the menu. Yeah, but by the way, as it is right now, I think that we have zero options to purchase.
Mm-hmm.
Or, yeah. I think that I will just play. They say that there is the Valkyr Prime Access pack, but if you go there...
Did you install the segment? Oh, that's it.
Yeah.
Okay.
I have never heard about that game menu. I have no idea. I think that there are a lot of games that are kind of in the limbo. And they will be they will go crazy whenever they actually deliver. You have one that I am kind of interested in acquiring, and I will be doing that eventually. The Elite Dangerous, mainly because I have the VR headset, and that game now has full support for VR. So I guess that it will be cool to fly a ship in VR. I said it will be a good match for that. So you are already in your ship, correct, with Demon?
Yeah.
Cool. So let me then try to invite you. Oh, this is navigation. Guess that. Oh no, here.
Got it.
Cool. Yeah, I think that, as I was saying, it's like early access games. I think that we are now in the era of AAA games that get like fully released, but then suddenly they are not that good and people ignore them. And early access games that have a lot of hype, people play it when they are released and people play whenever there is an update. And I think that we no longer have the usual game that you play, that you pay like normal price and you get the game and you play the game for a year or two and then you move on. I think that that era kind of ended.
You forgot the indies. Generally speaking, the indies are not in early access, or at least they don't.
They don't advertise as such.
They don't really,
Yeah, but they are.
They are generally almost complete when they are released.
Yeah, that's a fair. I think that the early access games nowadays are indies that are being developed by AAA developers that just got really tired of playing with EA, Ubisoft, and they just said, fuck them all, I have a bit of money, I will just create my own company, I will build my own game, because I want to have fun building my own game. So it's just like, an early access is kind of a mix, in my opinion, of a AAA game that is developed in indie stage, and so, as long as they don't overpromise, it's fine. I think that...
But those are only a small part.
Yes, but being honest, that those are the, it's like, I'm mainly playing those games nowadays.
It's asking me if I want to.
Yeah, because I just started the game. I've just selected a mission and someone just joined.
Oh, it's not Vorse Prize.
Well,
it's something else.
Okay.
The thing that you are joining, the mission.
But wait, so it was the only mission that was available.
Oh, okay.
When you go to navigation.
It was showing another name for me. That's why I asked.
No. I was saying that someone joined. Someone joined our squad. I need to see how to block the squad.
Okay.
Let me just, as soon as we are again back. It's a good idea to not... to not have a lot. So let me see. Give me just a moment. Communication.
Nobody else.
I know, but no, but the guy left.
Oh, okay.
So, you can have clans. I don't want to talk about clans. I want to talk about parties. Yeah, is what I said. This game is already a bit complicated. I think that is on the options. There is a way to... okay, so... Maybe this will prevent people from joining. I don't know. I guess that I need to go on YouTube and see a video on the internet to know how to limit this.
I see the shadows of your mind.
He keeps talking about the shadows of our minds.
we are really fat. That's the reason that we have shadows. I will let you know if I actually want to do that. Thank you very much for the offer. I will just check a couple of videos. See, I am really fast.
Yep.
If you double tap shift, you should be able to do the same, I think. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So.
I see some box.
By the way, is the loot shared or?
I don't know. There's more over here.
Yeah, I think that the loot is shared in the sense that when you break something, the loot will stay on the ground for both of us, I think. It's either that or you couldn't pick up that. Okay, we need to go through here.
Yeah.
But I mean, regarding loot, there are a lot of modes in this game that will allow you to like go through raids or stage raid phases, in the sense that you get like multiple raids coming in. So I think that we are okay for loot. We don't need to wog that much. I have no idea how to engage the guys.
Me neither.
Through melee or through...
Oh. What?
What? You fell, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, you can come back. Oh, you just got teleported back.
Yeah.
Cool. Oh shit.
Yeah.
By the way, there are some resources on the ground that you can break to pick up resources. I am going through a door.
Okay.
Cool, but the shooting is actually quite nice. It's like really focused, and if you hit the leg, you can break this guy's leg, and the headshots break their heads. It's swiftly done. Oh, you were here. That's the reason that I saw the guy being shot and not hitting the place that I was aiming to. I was like, what the fuck is happening? I'm shooting at his leg, and suddenly his head disappears. Whoa. By the way, I am actually actively considering buy the Nintendo Switch.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I mean, I will see. Let's see. Let's see how the thing goes. Like, whenever the thing is actually released. I'm curious to see. But I don't know if you are aware. But on Amazon... The pre-orders were available for a day. The day that the release was, like, when they announced the console, on that day you could pre-order. After that, forget it.
Yeah.
No longer available. Amazon just says currently unavailable.
Well, it's just a pre-order after all. Sure, you'll not get it on the first day, but.
My wife is just, because she is listening to this, she just showed me her phone with on the Nintendo site, the Nintendo Switch plus Zelda Breath of Wild on the basket.
Oh.
No, but we are not buying it yet. I mean, obviously you will be able to get stock, but you need to recall something. You were shooting at me, mate. I think that you were. But I don't think that you can cause... Oh no, there is a guy down here as well. No, but thing is, you will obviously be able to get more stock, but Nintendo usually messes up a bit with the stock.
This is the prison block. If you can avoid detection by the warden, it may be easier to get
I think that you need to come towards me, because there is like dual consoles here that need to be activated by two of us. And being honest, if I'm to buy the console, I would prefer to buy it through Amazon, because Amazon has a nice policy towards like devolutions and replacements. It's literally, if you have a problem, we give you one.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, it's like, for me, in my opinion, it's the most reliable online store. It's really, really cool. Cool, that's exactly what I came for. I came for a fight, and being completely honest, it's been a bit too slow. Oh, this guy is hard.
He was hard.
He was indeed. Is this a turret? Can I use the turret? Yes.
You can?
Yes, you can.
Cool.
No, no, she's not. My wife is not a Zelda fan. I think that she's never played or seen actively any of those games. She doesn't care for gaming, actually. But it's mostly the idea of... She cares for me, and that's the reason that she's talking about the game. Or seeing the game. So I'm no longer a rookie. It's amazing, according to the achievement on Steam.
Cool.
Oh, there are a lot of guys coming from the right side. And because the thing is, we are not using yet, but there are a lot of skills that this game has. This game is like a MOBA regarding skills. You will need to use a lot of skills and match them on your team. And that's like one of the things that this game has, is that mechanic. So I think that right now we are really, really low on skill level wise. And as soon as we have more skills, the game will actually start being more like combination and harder. Cool. I am so confused, I don't know where to go. Oh, I think that I opened the door and now we can go through the door. I feel like an old man playing this game. I get confused so easily. I'm like, what the fuck? Where the hell? Okay, so it seems that there is an elevator here. And we might need to go through the elevator. I think that these guys will continually spawn till we get to the point. I think that this is like a mission of let's get out of here.
Move forward.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe it wasn't.
What happened to you? No, it is, look here.
We are here.
No, but thing is, we came back because I went to a place to open a door. I actually activated the console and that told us to get back here to then go through the door. It was like a mission of go to a place, disable defenses and now come back. You have a guy behind you.
There's more.
Again, I think that this is...
Where the hell are you?
I stayed back. I'm going. I'm here. Cool. Oh, we need to open these doors. Cool. Oh, there is Davo here. We need to find Davo. And I just gave him a weapon. You just... No, you robbed his weapon, I think. Oh, no. No, he still has a weapon. So this is a rescue mission. I think that the big... not the big, but one of the weaknesses of this game is that the story doesn't grab you that much, and it's really hard for me to actually grab the context of the story, mainly because I'm streaming and I'm talking a lot. Yeah, it is true.
Come over here.
Okay, but there are a lot of games that you need to learn a lot. Why do you need to come through here?
Look at the map.
It is true. I will just unlock this shit. There we go.
being locked out. Let's override the security.
I think that I would like to have a sword instead of a stick. A sword seems cooler. Seems that we need to go higher. Yeah. There we go. Hacking the system. It's lovely that these guys are not only like excellent fighters, like crazy fighters, but also hackers. It's so nice that in the future everyone will be multi-skilled. You will be able to do everything. The future is brilliant. Oh, someone is shooting. Yeah, but I think that we already came through here. What we should actually... Oh shit, I'm now getting nailed. Yeah, the life is... The life was getting it. Yeah, by the way, whenever you start seeing a red glow around your body instead of a blue, it means that you are getting your life decreased instead of your shield.
Oh.
Yeah, that's the way that they show you if you are getting nailed by life or nailed by shield. And the life doesn't restore, just the shield. I don't know when we will be able to get our life back. They actually, I think that they do a nice animation whenever your shield gets down. What do we need to do now?
Come over here.
Okay, cool. This game seems to be a glitter world. Everything glows.
Yeah.
I will need to have a look into that, yeah. And another game that should be like really sick. I've heard that Batman has a nice mechanism to of fighting. Never played it.
Please, I guess.
Cool. Something happened to me.
Like what?
I am like mutating and getting a skill, I think. Yeah. I am either I am actually being fucked. He hacked my shield and now I cannot regen shield.
Damn.
My shield is like purple. And I can't get my shield back. Amazing. There are some guys coming from behind. Cool.
Do you need help?
No, I'm fine.
Let's just move forward.
Okay. Oh no, my shield is back now. But not regening still. It's strange. Smashed him. Is this the extraction point? Oh, yeah. Cool.
We were lost for a bit.
Yeah, it's like, as I told you, this game is mostly like you have a map and now you have this mission is about these objectives and now you will like transverse the map trying to get the objective. It's not like, oh, this is like focused and you will just do this. It's interesting in a way, being honest, but yeah. So now we need to look to locate the foundry. And where will I find weapons? Cool. I am now. I am able to mod my weapons.
Cool.
You don't have that yet?
I think so. Yeah. I need to install the thing.
Yeah, the segment.
What is it?
On the left side. As soon as you came from, as soon as you come from the main thing. Cool. Cool. I will be able to get different things. Using the new arsenal features. It is for the operator's own good. And we need to upgrade.
An excellent find, operator. There are hundreds of these mods to locate. If my calculations are correct, there are exactly a lot of possibilities. Install the mod
before we can continue. I have no mod. Oh, I do have a mod, yeah. Okay, so I can enhance. But what? I don't understand. It seems that there is a mechanism when you are installing mods that have like, that has like some icons. And I think that if you, oh, it's like you have the stance and you have something else. Strange. Mandurai. What's Mandurai? Combine heat and cold to create blast damage. I think that my current thingy, my stick doesn't have, it's not like good. Yeah. What?
Not a number. Did the operator enjoy this criticism?
Error, not a number. Oh, cool.
You go on upgrade and then there's mods there.
Yeah, I'm trying to install them. But I only have one capability. I can only install one mod because both of my mods only like use all my slots. Oh, okay. Cool.
Say, operator, your chosen warframe suits you.
Ha ha.
Vor's Ascaris is burrowing.
The AI is really sarcastic.
Yeah.
We must restore the
I think that there is a way for to like to affect your stance and that will provide you like different moves. But I don't understand where do you apply those. I need. Do I have Aura mods? No, I don't.
There is an auto install thing.
Where? On actions.
The bottom right.
Oh, yeah. Cool. Basically, that will just choose the best mods.
Yep.
Makes sense. And that will affect only that weapon, right? Not the other ones. I guess not. Cool. Yeah, that helps indeed. Oh, we have emotes. this game definitely has a lot. Cool. Essentially, you will need to pay money to get other frames, and you can earn money during the game, so that's nice. Cool. So, are you still dibbling through the options?
No, I already installed the mods.
Cool. So, I just selected the mission, and... essentially, whenever you want, you can just accept. Yeah, I'm not sure if the other guy that joined, he joined because he was looking for the same mission, and the game is doing auto matchmaking whenever you're joining a mission. That's quite possible.
Yeah.
Or if he actually looked for me, I don't know, or for you. I don't know.
Well, they don't know us, I guess.
No, but it's like, but whenever you are playing like this type of games, it's nice to play with people, regardless if you know them
or
not.
Yeah, yeah, I get it. But so, we are new players, so they shouldn't know us.
But they might be new players as well. And like, as soon as you... No, it might be like an auto matchmaking thing. You still have a job to do. Find the boundary segment.
I hate when mods go to waste out of boundaries. It's not cool.
I don't know how the mods look like, to be honest. Not yet, at least. This was once a prosperous independent colony
until the Grineer arrived. I was trying to use my weapon, but it doesn't let me.
Do you have ammo or?
Maybe it's that, yeah.
Oh, I see. The dots that you have on your crosshair means that you can change your attack. So, for instance, on my pole, I have two attacks. The radial blind, or the slash dash.
There's guys here.
Cool.
Rank up. Uh-oh. You've
been seen. Oh, you came. Oh, you're still here. Cool. I think that they are downstairs.
I don't see you anymore.
Oh wait, there is... seems that there is something here as well. Yeah. No, I think that we need to go downstairs. Through these... Oh, I see. We need to hack the systems to do something. And the consoles are marked by the white icon. And the...
Where the hell are you?
Wait.
Oh.
Cool.
Right here.
Yeah. Yeah, we need to go downstairs, I think. Through here. Oh, shit. This is not downstairs. Maybe through this door. Yeah, this door, yeah. I am like a Jedi.
Yeah.
I think that we need to do something on the console behind us. No. Okay. Okay, no, no, ignore me, ignore me. We need to plow through. And yeah, we need to go through this pipe here.
I think
This area is completely useless. Why the fuck would someone build a platform that has no ending? I think that the consoles that we usually hack are just to disable the alarms. So the white icons is just disabling alarm thing.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. I just picked up the foundry.
One step closer to completion. Now, there is one more thing you need to do. Eliminate all Grineer and provide justice for the colonists.
Cool. Now it's the vengeance mission.
Let's go back.
The worm will be in your spine, and I will control this warframe of yours. I will purge your doting mother and bring you home.
Wait, no, it's here, downstairs. Oh, it's a guy here. Is that the guy? Well, this is a bit silly. What the fuck do we need to do? And I'm dying. Yep, I died. And I think I will die again. No. What the hell is happening here? Yeah, there is a guy. And seriously, we just had to kill one. We need to now pick up everyone.
Yeah, but the thing is, the guy was deactivated when I... That's, I was next to him and he was like... He was waking up and I was like, what?
This mission is a bit silly. Now you need to go and pick up enemy by enemy. It seems that I have energy. I don't know how I restore my energy. I see. I need to pick up energy in order to do my boosts. Go. I get it that it is Avengers and whatnot, but killing enemy by enemy, it's a bit. Why not a big boss or something like that?
It will come probably.
Oh, okay. Okay, we are now getting... Oh, I've seen this. Yeah, I think that usually this is how you trigger missions or something. This system here. Mm-hmm. Need to get into those slots. Or maybe the end of the mission is always getting into these slots to get back to your ship. Oh no, actually that's the interface with the ship, is that slot.
Okay.
Your foundry segment is ready for installation, operator. Will the operator build a cephalon to replace me?
It seems that now we can 3D print stuff. Yep.
Foundry restored. Here the operator will craft many powerful weapons.
Basically we're just unlocking things in the ship.
Yeah, it's the beginning, yeah. And it seems that now we can craft shit.
Operator, our component storage has been looted as well.
Oh, we don't. Yeah, now it's the next thing is we don't have components. We need to go in the mission and recover the components.
Jack up the components. Operator, we will need resources in order to build the countermeasure blueprint.
Tenno, I just received a very explicit message from your ship Zevlon. If you're looking for
the guy is Russian.
You just say so.
Yeah.
Just a place, but I demand an apology. My mother is no gymnast. She would never eat those things.
You can go straight to operator. I am sorry.
Wow.
No. The AI was trying to tell the guy to go fuck himself.
That one seems glitched. I've marked your navigation with the place I
know. Cool. Shall we go to that place that he's talking about?
Yeah, sure.
So we have like, we have, we can go to Eurasia, raid the Corpus resource caches, or Lit. What do you prefer? Eurasia?
Yeah. Cool. Wait, isn't that too high level for us?
What's our level?
I don't really know, but I know that the mission has levels.
Yeah, but let me then check my level. How do I check my level? Show profile. I don't know what's my level, to be honest. I mean, we can go for a lower level. I have... Okay, so we can just take one. We can take the one for the cash then. Cool. Yeah. I think that that's another thing that they are not like really explicit is leveling. And I think that everything has a level here. Weapons have a level. Your gun has a level. By the way, you can actually drive your ship in this menu.
Oh, cool.
There we go.
Suggests that this outpost is host to several rich supply caches.
Most fell.
This outpost belongs to the Corpus. A secretive but extremely powerful merchant cult known to be working with the Grineer. Darvo will fill you in.
Legions of robots, mindless automatons, freaking lasers. These guys are bad news, but they're also loaded, which is why you're here. technically this is steel.
I think they are making corpses.
They are making like bodies or corpses?
Bodies.
Okay. Making corpses is actually a funny process of getting a live sample and shooting him in the head.
Here.
Yeah. Oh, but these guys have shields. These guys are more interesting. Yeah.
You have murdered my sons and disgraced me before my queens.
Yeah, these guys are funnier to attack.
Where the hell are you?
I am just running forward. But there is a cache behind us. Okay, cool. No, this is not the cache. Shit. Okay.
Alarms have been reset.
I have no idea where these caches are, but I think that they are far. I think that the game is like pointing us to a lot of places. Oh wait, is it here? No. I think that there is one there. Oh, here we go.
Find the next cache. You almost have what you need.
Cool, we already grabbed one cache, just so you know. The game just told me something. You have been playing for over an hour. Please don't forget to take a break.
Yeah.
Real life guarantees that I take breaks. Relax, game. I think it's a bit excessive to throw these warnings after an hour, just an hour.
A little bit.
Yeah. 8 hours? Yes, I agree. I got now an hour. I think that I will break my shift key by pressing it so many times just to move faster. Cool. I just grabbed the last thingy.
The Ascaris has reached your mind and rendered your lotus mute. You will return to me.
It seems that the guy that appears on the cinematic is always trying to mess up with us.
Yeah.
Well, an explosive barrel doesn't seem a good thing to Millie, right?
So. It depends. It's a piñata.
I don't think that it... I don't...
Maybe
I really don't like the idea.
Piñata.
Maybe I am, yeah. Whoa, where do I need to go? Okay.
Here.
Cool.
You are mine.
Yeah, I think that this mission was too easy. I don't know how do you feel about it, but I think that we need to go for an higher mission. Because it's like, we are just like walking through and it's not, we have nothing like to, it's like just okay, just like let's walk slowly.
Operator, are you all right?
No, I'm getting bored. Something a bit more elaborated, please. Let's put a bit more difficulty here, if it is possible.
But now, I am part of you.
This guy is annoying.
Yeah, I was thinking that.
The guy is a bit like, it's a side, it's a villain.
Oh, you have a flaw? Tell me about it then.
But now, we have you.
Okay, so it seems that there is a, we can buy something that removes the guy from our... Yeah, I will just build the Ascaris Negator and he will no longer annoy us in 25 seconds. If you go to the foundry, you can buy something that will like remove you from your remove him from your system, because this is getting a bit upsetting. Cool, 15 seconds and this motherfucker will no longer be part of this game. It's annoying. Screw you, mate. Go away.
And I will die at last. At peace. Father. Grandfather.
Boom. So now we need to claim these. So it seems that now if we go to our inventory... Cool, so now we, the guy is no longer part of us. Yep.
What a waste. Take that.
Tenno. Good. You managed to disarm Boris Ascaris. I thought I lost you.
But we can upgrade. Yeah, but that costs money.
Guy goes with what a waste.
Yeah, indeed.
We are tripping.
Yeah, I would love to have something nicer than this. And
Ordis assumes finding Vor implies violence. Hello, operator. May I suggest you access navigation and save your life? For my sake.
I'm getting angry.
Why? Something related to the game?
No, not at all.
I was finding it
strange. It's a general feeling, you know?
Mm. Yeah, usually I compartmentalize my life and I have those times that I actually have my meals, so... Cool, so it seems that now... Yeah, we have a lot of missions, I don't understand this. We can like select missions to go to different places. It seems that we can follow the path to go to to Venus or to Mars.
Wow. Well, I guess Venus is generally accepted as female and Mars male.
So let's then go for Venus then?
Venus.
Okay, cool. We can either go for the lead mission that is a defense or for the Griner mission, for the Griner faction.
Granier.
And that's Granier, yeah, and that's, yeah, a spy. We can gather. Do you want to like do this continuously in the sense of go from like do the first mission then the second one? I guess that makes sense, right?
Whatever.
To just complete the path. Yeah, this will still be a level one mission.
Yeah.
We're going to lead.
I was about to shout out some memes, but I realized that you don't get it, so
Yeah, unfortunately, I am a bit disconnected with the meme thing. I actually don't understand how to get it. Maybe lack of internet contact. Oh, you have a sword. You do have a sword.
Yeah.
Yeah. I have a stick.
But I can't use it, I don't know why.
E, if you press E. Can you press E? There you go.
Fuck. I'm so bad.
Wait.
Somebody joined the squad, what?
Yeah. I don't understand.
Slow down. Somebody is here. I think he's showing off.
Yeah, I don't know how to kick people.
He's doing the mission alone. What?
I mean, this is annoying. Why the hell can't we just... Why can't we say that our thing is...
Yeah, he's triggering shit.
Yeah, we are essentially being trolled. Give me just a moment and I will try to do something about
it. Well, it's not trolling. It just doesn't know.
Yeah, but thing is, why do we need to have that? Why can't we have something private?
I don't know.
It's what I'm telling you, I need to watch a YouTube video to teach me how to get that. Yeah, because this is...
That's a screw.
Yeah. Because it's like, you don't even have an option to... We can only invite people. You can't like limit your squad. I think that's like one of... And now we have another guy. So we have like, we are now playing with a lot of guys. Ah, shit. Yeah, this is... this mission is like Gears of War missions in which you have a lot of guys. Oh. It's like just a defense, it's like a wave system.
He left.
We actually had two.
Oh, okay.
So one of them left. Okay, the other one left as well, cool. By the way, we need to protect this thing in the middle. You need to stay in the middle and protect this thing. Cool, the thing is now recovering life and shield. It was getting a bit miserable. First wave cleared. And wave 2. How lovely. Okay, you are covering that side, I will cover your back then.
Yeah.
One thing that I'm missing is grenades, and I know that the game has grenades, because the enemies throw grenades, but it would, sometimes they aggregate in a place, it would be lovely to kill them all. Yeah, definitely staying put in one place is not the type of game. This game is not focused on that. If you just stay in one place, you are in a great disadvantage. go. Wave two then. Did you fail?
Nope.
I just saw you kind of respawning.
Nope.
This seems to be a Warframe cryopod, so we might get a friend. And it seems that there is a way to recruit a Tano. I don't know what a Tano is, but it might be like...
This guy's like a...
But okay, so it's like a bot, or we are talking? Are we talking about recruiting a real guy? So we are Thanos then. I don't have enough time to reload. Grenade.
Where are they?
This side. Yeah, we have no orientation regarding like east or west.
Yeah.
So it cool. This guy has an auto thing on his head, so I guess that we can have like attachments. He has like a bot on the top of his head. And I guess that he will kill everyone. By the way, if you are mid-jump, you can right-click with the weapon and that will do like a slow motion. I'm getting a lot of mods. There is an enemy coming from this side. Where is he? I think that the guy is bugged and he's not coming. Yeah, he is bugged. He's stuck in the map. He was stuck on the map.
Oh.
He will never come to us. By the way, if this game is done properly, because this guy is here and he's a really high level, we will see a lot of enemies coming because of him. I have a grenade attached to me. Lovely. Cool. I would say that we are level 3 or 4 now, because the enemies are level 3. and they are fairly accessible. Where are the enemies? Cool. Do you choose to
leave now or continue? Should we extract or battle?
I don't know. Do you want to battle?
No.
Battle. You don't want to battle?
No.
Okay, so then select extract.
Okay.
Cool. Yeah, I think that...
Mission complete?
No, yeah, the idea is you can keep here, and this is the way that you get more items, and you get... Right. I thought that it was battle PvP.
No, it was, I thought that it was okay for us to just leave now.
It is okay. The mission was actually done. But the idea is, every single defense mission allows you to, keep going. Yeah. Yeah, and that way it's like, it gives you more, and it becomes a bit harder. But at the same time, it helps you to, get more stuff. So I'm just selecting the next mission.
Okay.
And this one is not, it's not a defense mission. It's a spy mission.
Oh man, we are going to suck.
And I don't know, I think that this game will never have the true stealth spy.
I think we already have somebody else in the team.
Two guys, yeah, this is definitely using auto matching. Yeah, see here. I don't know, we have to have an option to that. I have no idea what's that option. But are you really bothered with these guys here? I don't know.
Kind of, because they already know the game and we don't.
That's true, yeah. I will, when the stream ends, I will actually go and watch a YouTube video to learn how to...
Okay.
For in the near...
Look at that. This guy already has lots of skins and shit.
Yeah. The thing is, what's the fun of playing this game? Back missions or missions that are... Shit, there are some dogs here that jump on you. Because, this is really, really easy for them. Shit, these dogs are really, really, really hard to beat. I am going to point A. By the way, these dogs are really tough. I don't know if you have seen the dogs yet.
Yeah.
But these guys are... I think that the only reason that we are killing them is because there was one guy here that has a lot of health and a lot of damage, and he's doing a lot of damage to these guys. Shit. Oh, I see. I got it. So essentially, you need to if you are not stealth, they will destroy the data and you lose the mission. Oh, the door just opened. No, it didn't. None of the scanners have detected you. What happened? Alarms. Data destruction is imminent. You need to hurry. What the fuck? Where is the... I am confused. cool. I don't know how to open the door. Is this button? Cool. We just got A. And I think that someone in our team already got B. No, sorry, C. I think that this game has like global event. I don't know if you just saw this notification. It seems that there is like I think that they will just like apply events depending on the hour or something, like to generate interest in an area. It's an interesting concept. The target console is nearby. If you trigger the alarms now, the enemy will start destroying data.
Alarms have been triggered. You need to retrieve that data before the data destruction is complete.
Well.
Oops. That's a shocking realization.
Yes, indeed. What was the button? Oh, I guess it's like the clicking on the on the space bar. Done.
Data integrity verified. Retrieval was successful.
By the way, when you go through that barrier, you lose your shield for a bit.
Oh, okay.
Shit, I just jumped into the water. No, it's
not shocking anymore.
Cool. I'm lazy, I'm just taking the elevator. Now we need to get C. I got stuck on a tree. Yeah, this guy has an ability that does like chain damage to everyone and even stuns them.
Yeah.
This just wrecks these poor beasts. Shit, a grenade.
What are you guys doing?
We were fighting a couple of dogs.
Oh.
That appeared suddenly. Oh, this is a glass. If you trigger the alarms now, the enemy will start destroying data. Whoa, this is strange. How do we get up there? Okay, there is a... We have stairs here, yes. Cool. You can, your boy Mafia. Really low level and no idea what I'm doing, and we have only three guys in, so yes, I think that you can join. IGRCNDD is the ID. You are completely fine to join. Yes, now we need to jump to there. Oh, there is a zipline. Oh, how did you... I don't have that option.
Just click X near it.
Oh, okay, I got it. Give me just a moment. Okay, I can't invite you yet, your boy Mafia, because we are... seems that the objective is already completed, sorry about that. I don't know why it's saying that the objective is already completed, because we still have to activate one point. Cool.
Wow.
I think that they actually know, because if we fought a lot of them, so I doubt that they wouldn't know, only if they are really, really stupid. Oh, wrong place. Cool, I will invite you now. It seems that we have I'm getting a lot of mods, which is cool.
Oh, I think I'm going to take my leave now, because I'm hungry, you know?
fair enough, mate, no worries. I will...
You can also click 1 to use your power, I think it's 1 through 5.
Yeah, powers. But you can choose that on the actual weapon.
Oh, okay.
You don't need to... You can just like scroll up or down.
Okay.
Cool. So the Mexican Mafia is already with us.
Thanks for the game.
Thank you.
I'll be back someday.
Cool. Someday I will see you then. Have a nice one, mate. And I will be continuing for a bit as well. Let me just quickly rebalance my shit. I'm not paying a lot of attention to the mods yet. Just applying them, and then we will continue with the line of mission that I was doing before. Give me just a moment, I will... what do you mean by my name? Okay. So now we have a test. I would need to exit the squad to rank up. I will rank up eventually. I guess that's just a mission to evolve and whatnot. Not too worried about that. I will do that eventually. So I will do it then. So I will exit the squad. And I will invite you in a bit then. Just a moment. Is that really important?
A Tenno must be a master of all their weapons.
I guess that's the reason that I am still rank 0. Oh. So, I need to use my first weapon. Can't use my melee weapon. Cool. Come on. There we go. Cool. No more.
A formidable performance. This test is now complete. Another job well executed.
Cool. Ranked.
When you are ready, proceed to the navigation console.
Rank 1. Amazing. We then invite you again. I'm inviting you back. Cool. So, I mean, I'm just going through the mission, so I don't know why, but I am going to Venus. Shit, single player, so I will do that afterwards. Let's just do the Eurasia one then. Cool. Are you new to the game? Let me just re-enable the voice, because I was just using Discord. No. Oh.
This is a mobile defense mission. You must deliver payloads and defend a number of locations while I break into the network.
Where is the voice?
Prepare for heavy resistance.
Cool, so now I have the voice, so I will be able to hear you. Yeah, I have never... Yeah, you don't look new at all. Indeed, you look... Your character looks... far from new.
We have got to find a terminal. Proceed and prepare.
I am carrying the box.
Location reached. Drop me in and defend our position.
There we go. So the AI was in the box. Crazy stuff.
Still working on it. Continue to defend.
Working really slow on that. These guys are also ninjas. Everyone in this universe is a ninja. Cool. Look at this aim. Really, really weak aim. So, guess I need to pick this shit up again. And let's move on. Oh, cool. Can use the melee even with the box. That's sweet. Oh, you know, I have multiple areas, so. Shit. The dogs. These dogs are really annoying. Your weapon is really cool, mate. It exhausts radiation. Really healthy weapon. Possibilities.
We are finished here. Move on.
Let's go then, girl. Let us go. Jumping through mines and all.
Upload me and prepare to defend.
Here we go. Always here to defend you. Do not worry. It always takes a moment. It always does. And let's kill all these bastards. The usual route. Whoa, you have a shade. What the hell?
Still working on it.
Recover a bit of shield. More dogs. Sweet. Yeah. The odds are always against us. It's lovely. I guess that we shouldn't be playing on the lottery, because the odds are always against us. It's always lovely. I guess that now we need to extract. Shiny light that doesn't do anything. Whoa, where is the extraction then? Oh, guess that I'm going the wrong way. Yeah. Let's go. More dogs, lovely. Oh, I guess that this game is mostly composed of people running by rolling on the ground. Lovely. I guess that you dealt just a tiny bit more damage than I did. 23% to 77%. I guess that was a bit useless.
When you are ready, proceed to the navigation console.
Let us go then. Excavation mission. we can do the Cervantes as well. Cool. Well, I really need to... Oh, we can, yeah, we can just start a mission. And that also works. Oh, okay. I will just... I think that you already did all these missions, so I will do that, and I will just quickly do this mission, and then I will just let me know whenever you are ready, and I will invite you again. So I guess that this game does auto matchmaking, just to keep you company, which makes sense, I guess. Or else you would be a bit lonely. Cool.
An artifact has been located. Proceed to the dig site.
Let's go to the dig site. Protected. Ooh. Well, a lot of guys here. Guess that I am down. Guess that I need to find a better sword. Just revived. I guess that I need to switch to the melee if I am interested in meleeing. Hello, Lomov, how are you doing, mate? Everything is fine. Oh, let me see if I can revive the chap. Let's see if I can... Cool. Yes, I survived. Excavator destroyed. Protect the remaining dig sites. How are you doing, mate? These guys are tough as nails. And I ran out of energy. I guess that the problem is that we need to advance and we are not doing so, so they will keep spawning. So let us go to the next space then. I guess that my stick is not as good as I thought. Might as well use another weapon. And my weapon is not good enough. Definitely not good enough. So these guys have the thing that feeds power. Oh, look at this slow motion. Okay, so it seems that now we are actually clearing a bit more. Or let's say doing a bit well, better. Shit. I'm about to go under now. Let's just try to avoid that. Cool, so it seems that we first of all, we just try to revive this guy. There are a lot of guys here. At least now they are fighting the dogs.
We need another power cell for the excavator.
So we need to pick up a power cell. And then we need to put it here. Cool. And I guess that this is how things will work. So we need to kill these guys, pick up the cell, and put the cell in place. There we go. Yeah, this should work and help. It seems that now we are doing that more. Cool. Can we drop it? So it seems that we can't drop the backpack or the power cell, which is strange, or let's say annoying. Come on, mate, just drop that. Okay, it just dropped it. I don't know where is the other guy that was with us. Yeah, look at him.
Cool.
I thought that we were extracting now. I don't understand. I think that the game will allow us to just keep going. There we go. I guess that no one is coming here then. Yeah.
Oh.
I guess that everyone wants to do all the extractions. And I was just getting out. Fair enough. But then just pick this up. Shit, I didn't pick that up. Being completely honest, I don't know why I am doing this. But okay, I guess that everyone is now ready to to get out. I am just going there as well. I think that they are there.
Excavator destroyed. Protect the remaining dig sites.
No, they are not here yet. I guess that they are coming here now, cool. Where are they? No, they are, I think. No, enemies are coming here, not them. A lot of enemies, actually. Here we go. Cool. Finally extracting. Cool. Seems that I was in mid-tier regarding damage and whatnot. That's cool. That's cool. Let's see if we have another rank up available now.
When you are ready, proceed to the navigation.
No, not yet. I'm no longer. Let us see if we can change a bit again. Now we have way more space, I guess, because we ranked up, which is cool. Yeah, now essentially we can equip almost all of our mods. I would say that in the beginning I won't be like focusing specifically on these or that. I will just be just like applying wherever and doing the things automatically. Oh, I see. So, the thing is, yeah, the matchmaking is set here. I didn't saw that before. Cool, so I guess that... I will just go to the Venus Junction. Check out what's happening there. Seems that this is actually a is this a fighting mission? Oh, I see. So it is impossible to get through here, because we need to essentially do. We need to do the mission in order to get through. Cool. So that's the reason that we can't go yet. We need to do a quest. Cool, so need to do a couple more missions before we actually do that. What?
When you are ready, proceed to the navigation console.
Are you serious, mate? So I am still to understand what's happening with the quests. It seems that we need to do this. Oh, they are here. So we have quests that are not on the map. Strange, really strange. I love that the beginning of every single mission is getting through like a cache or like a vent. I don't understand. Fair enough. Boom. Yeah, unfortunately, I kind of understand, so. But yeah, there is a lot of people that would fall for that.
You have murdered my sons and disgraced me.
I was stuck.
But soon, the Ascaris will complete its task.
Tough shit, I guess. I think that the difficulty in the game is to be able to play with that, with those images in the middle of the screen. It's quite harsh. Boom, the guy was trying to run away, but I guess that that was not possible. Why the hell are they trying to retreat just against one guy? Doesn't seem to make a lot of sense. I don't need to act the security. Well, sniper makes a the sniper makes an interesting sound. Well, I guess that I should first pick this up. Go. They are all upstairs. There we go. And we need to come through here. And raise this, wherever this is. Collect the segment. We have what we wait.
Put the galleon on a direct course to a convoy of colonists. You have a choice. You can extract now, or you can disable this galleon and save the colonists.
I mean, we could be nice guys.
Saving the colonists could jeopardize this mission. I recommend you head straight to extraction. But the choice is yours.
I don't know what to do.
The Ascaris failsafe is attacking your systems. Your
ship well.
Capacity has just been halved. You're wasting precious time, Tenno.
I guess that we'll extract. Because we are assholes. And that's what assholes usually do. The guy runs faster than I attack, so I cannot melee him while he's running. There we go. Guess that no availability to melee him. Too far away from me. It's lovely how in the game you just smash everything. Cool.
The colonist ship has been lost. I know it was a difficult choice, but many more in the future depend on your survival.
It wasn't that a difficult choice, to be honest. It was fine. Cool. Let us then continue.
Proceed to the navigation console.
Isn't that we have something here? Oh, it's on the navigation system, I guess. No, we actually have a... Yeah, we had a thing, a segment.
The heat drives me. Solar rail navigation to Mercury enabled, operator.
So now we need to to fight against the guy.
Charging up, you need to bring Vor down.
Boom. A mission with other people.
Don't worry, I will be with him. Let us show him how.
I guess that the communication was cut in off, so there was no showing. Or there is no showing, actually. Alright, else I don't know what I will be showing.
This is our chance. Vor has been stripped of his elite guard. He is vulnerable. Take him out.
Boom. So the mission starts with this stupid elevator just for a level when we are able to jump buildings. It's always an hard choice to decide to go after every fucking enemy or to just like go on. These elevators are annoying. Why are they making these? Ooh. Oh, I guess that I see. Chap is coming with us. Amazing.
I will put you down like a rabbit.
I guess that you are. He wants to push us down. We might need to fight back. Guess. Oh, a guy with a shield, interesting. New mechanic. Need to go left. Go. Cool. Oh, nice! First boss.
Strike through the Rhenir.
The assassination target is here. Wipe out.
Cool. And is he dead? No, of course not. Oh, got it. So the idea is to just go from damage phase to damage phase, then fight against. And I just made a big mistake. I fell. That's not. Come on.
Look,
Cool, he died. Amazing. I don't know if I would have picked this up if I hadn't pressed X. That kind of concerned me, because that seems to be an interesting item. It seems that you need to really press on all the items. I really don't like snipers, so... Sorry, the other guy is already going for extraction, and I don't know where the extraction is. Oh, is it here? No, this is not the right place to go for the extraction. Yeah, we need to go for the extraction. Where? Well, I am confused. It seems to be to go through here. Up? Well, how the hell would we be able to go up? What? I don't get it. I really don't get it. Oh, I guess that we need to go back then. Yeah. Cool. Always obvious, right? Or maybe not. Ooh, maybe I... I said I was going too down. Too fast. Come here, don't run away. Why not kill him? I need to go down. There we go, and this is definitely the place to go for extraction. I guess that this chap was kind of bugging out a bit. Too slow. There we go. Is it through here? Yes, it is. Ooh. Yeah, cool. Boom, extracted. Amazing. By the way, this game is totally free, so a game that provides this type of content, this kind of fun and being free, it's pretty cool. It is definitely cool.
Cool. The origin system is in chaos, and it needs you, Tenno.
Amazing.
Vor was just a part of the Grineer machine.
I am needed.
And they've seen that the Corpus have begun amassing weapons of their own. It is a dangerous time.
Well.
Gladius is the operator in cutting a bloody path in whatever mission they choose.
We will be at your side. There will be others too.
Means that we have now more slots. Now we will do everything, right? Why not?
Your chosen warframe suits you.
These dry jokes are really fun, or not? Let's see. Can we select a different warframe? Not yet. Yeah. we need to essentially complete more. We would need to complete more more missions to do so. So let's have a look then. So now we need to do the price. So where do we need to go to get the price? Here? I mean, it seems that that's the thing, right? They could give a bit more of explanation. I have no idea. Maybe it's here, maybe it's not. It's a mission, so might as well do it. Cool.
Their efforts. Start with the toxin mixer. But I am unable to pinpoint their exact.
This really seems the same. The same mission that we did on the tutorial, or at least the same map. That this kill wouldn't count as a stealth kill. That would be like utter bullshit. Is this guy dead? Oh, he was not dead. A lot of flip-flops is what I have to say. This game is just a bunch of strange things. Cool. Here we go. Amazing. Oh, it's a player. I guess that at this rate we will actually get the stealth without doing like a big push on it. Thank you very much for getting our stealth kill. Okay, fair enough. So we need to destroy it, and you need to be careful so the guy just melees it. When? What? Cool. Guess that they can't spawn anymore. Yeah, these dogs are really annoying, by the way. Not nice dogs. Guess that we need to go down then. There we go. Always fun to traverse these maps. This seems like a nice farming place, because we essentially are just killing them all. Oh, it seems that one actually got out. Ooh. A lot of them. Might as well continue now. But we seem to need something in order to activate this. This one of our mates possesses what we need, or not at all. I guess that not at all. Oh, it's actually working. Cool. 90%. These dogs are annoying, by the way. I don't know if I said that before. Well, almost fell.
Tenno, there are still undiscovered supply caches in the area.
I don't know why these guys kill the dogs. Cool. This guy is a bull. The bullman. Amazing. I want the damage dealt. I guess that killing all those dogs on that place helped. Cool. Explanations. And we just finished our quest. Amazing. Let's just again rebalance all the mods. I guess that's something that we will always do. It's always the process is to come here and to balance. I guess that on the machine gun it's no longer needed because we already have all the spots available. But on the ones, yeah, we still have. Oh, I think that actually we got more slots now. Yes, cool. Here we go. Perfect. Let's just carry on. And now we no longer have quests. Actually, I think that now we are... Upgrade any mod to rank 2 or higher through the fusion process. So, let's just do that. I don't think that this is what we need to do. I have no idea how to upgrade a mod. So we need to upgrade any mod that we have. Can we select by the ones that are equipped?
Everything in orders, operator? Is that a pun?
It seems that, yeah, it's like... It's just like selecting whatever. Cool. And I don't know if I'm using the mod or not, so it could be completely useless. So let's just fusion these. And I think that we need to have the mod at rank 2. Cool. Now we have a rank 2 mod. And I guess that we are able to continue to Venus then. Yes, indeed. Now we can go to Venus. Maybe get some rewards and then move there. Oh, cool. So this guy has a shield. Oh, I see. So essentially the guy is really like really focused on melee. Seems that the guy sometimes gets a bit, gets slightly bigger. There you go, and he's done. I think it's like a really nice idea for them to implement kind of defenders that prevent you from going to place to place. And we even got some mods to balance things out. Cool. So we have, what happens if we click here? Yeah, this, let's, I would say let's just try to finish all missions on Earth. Seems that we don't have, we need to possess the Archwing. I don't think that we have the Archwing quest yet. Bazaars are as well, and I guess that, yeah, this one will be one to do whenever shit happens. So let's just do this gate then instead. Is happening in here then?
Eliminate all corpus threats.
Not useful. Fighting against the wall, I guess. A mission to kill everyone. Fun mission. These guys are bugged out, so they don't... They are not trying to attack. Oh. Cool. So... Oh, okay. Got it. Cool. The guy was trying to run away. Not acceptable, mate.
You've been seen.
I'm not worried about being seen. It's fine.
Alarms have been reset.
Well, our teammate seems to be a bit upset being seen. Here we go, down again. Oh, it's up actually. The next guy is up here. The guy with shield and all. That then deals a lot of damage. Oh. Cool, he discovered the place. Disable these. Yeah, not a good idea. We are frozen. Not a good idea to break those containers. These ones are cool, the other ones are not. I don't know what will happen if we only have one guy. Will we open these doors? Guy was stuck on the wall. This is always a nice mission to kill everyone. Like, wipe everyone. The guy is here. And I almost fell. There is a guy behind us, and if we leave him, then we are screwed. Did he die? I think that he did. There's another guy here. I guess that is they spawn when we move from area to area. Cool, and now we need to continue again to this area. Yeah, they're respawning. There we go. This guy was trying to be sneaky. It's not today, Jose, not today. I guess that's because we need to kill enemies. Raising the alarm would be actually something really nice. That way we'd be able to just finish this rather quickly. We're actually not that far right now. Three more to go, I guess. One more to go. There we go. And we are really close to the extraction, or are we not? No, we aren't. Kind of close. Yeah, we were fairly close. Cool. Here we go. Mission finished. Amazing. Cool. I would say that it's a nice game. Obviously, it's not like the best game in the world, because I mean, free game and whatnot, but it is a, I would say, a nice, acceptable game to play, and something that is fun, and something that you can come and pick up, because look at all the planets that we have right now. Cool, yeah, but essentially, yeah, it will be something that I will undoubtedly visit again soon, but not guaranteed tomorrow. Tomorrow we'll be back again at the schedule of 22 BST GMT, sorry. I hope that you guys have a nice wherever you are, evening, night, morning. I will be back tomorrow, as I said, at 22 GMT, very likely with RimWorld. Thank you very much for watching, and thank you very much for letting me entertain you. I will catch you again tomorrow. Have a nice one. Bye. Excuse me.